Alright, in this tutorial, still on the topic of making your videos look more professional and polished, I'll be sharing a few quick tips on consistency. Yeah, consistency is not as glamorous as smooth animations and effects, but especially if you create more than one screencast, your ability to create videos that visually tell viewers,
"Hey, I go with that other one you saw."
Or even,
"I wasn't created by three people."
Even if it was, can be pretty important. The first tip is to use title slides that look the same. This can be as simple as having one image and adding title text with Camtasia in each video. Just be sure to use the same font and font styles throughout. Tip 2. Use the same color or small set of colors for annotations. We covered this a bit in the tutorial on annotations, but it's important enough to repeat. If you do have specific colors, you can change the defaults by going to Preferences in the Camtasia 2 menu. And in the General tab, click on any color you want to change. Then, use the Apple Color Picker to select the new color. Close the windows when you're done. Now, the new color will appear in all of the properties where you can select a color. Tip 3. Save your custom annotation styles. Remember how we changed the color and size of the arrow here? Wouldn't it be great not to have to make those changes every time we want an arrow just like that? Well, it's easy. Click on the arrow to select it. And in the annotations properties, if you make any change to it, you'll see this Save button. Click it, then go to the Annotations tab on the left. In the Arrows group, you'll now see the arrow. Not only will that style of arrow be available for the rest of this project, but will be in Camtasia for other projects as well. You can also save styles for all the other kinds of annotations as well. I love this feature. Bonus tip, use the same dimensions for all videos. As covered in an earlier tutorial, you set the canvas by choosing Adjust Canvas from this dropdown. Where possible and practical, try to edit all of your videos at the same size. This will mean that all of your videos are exported at the same size. There are, of course, exceptions based on the different places you may share video, but it's a good default to follow. That's it for the tips. Feel free to try out some of these tips on your project, or just jump ahead to the next tutorial where we'll explore some ways to get better sounding audio. See you there.